Google just announcing a major overhaul to its smart home systems, now using its AI expertise to bring the Gemini model into devices like Nest and smart speakers. Mackenzie Segalos has the details.
All right, here's what's new with Google's smart home, and it's a lot. So let's just talk through it. We're hanging out in the kitchen setting up gear. And the big shift is that Gemini, yeah, their most capable AI, is now the foundation. It's called Gemini for Home, and it doesn't just sit in one product. It replaces Google Assistant on speakers and smart displays, upgrades the brains of your cameras and doorbells, and powers a completely redesigned Google Home app. They're rolling it out in early access starting this month, with speakers and smart displays beginning toward the end of the month. The pitch is simple. The smart home moves from basic commands to actual collaboration. Gemini for Home is tuned for the way a home works. People walking around, multiple users, lots of devices, and you wanting stuff done without fuss. On voice, you get 10 new, more natural-sounding voices with realistic pacing and intonation, and the system keeps context. So you can say, "Hey Google, my dishwasher isn't draining. What should I check first?" Then follow with, "The filter looks good. What next?" And it sticks with the dishwasher. For media, you can be human about it. Play the song from the movie where a bunch of oil workers fly to space to blow up an asteroid. Or play a recent podcast featuring Sundar Pichai, and it understands. For smart home control, it reads contexts like where you are. If you're upstairs and say you're about to cook, it can turn on the stove lights downstairs. It now handles complex requests with exceptions, like turn off all the lights except for the office lights. And it just does it. For household coordination, it stops being a dumb note taker and starts reasoning. Add ingredients for pad thai to my shopping list. Then it asks about diet or portions and fills the list. Set a timer for making an egg and it figures out the time. If you want free-flowing talk, there's Gemini Live. Start with, "Hey Google, let's chat," then drop the hot word and just talk. Pause, interrupt, pivot. Brainstorm a dinner from, "I have spinach, eggs, feta, and some bread." Turn it keto-friendly and constrain it to what your kids will actually eat, all in one back and forth. Same vibe for planning a surprise birthday party. Gemini riffing on an old Hollywood theme all the way down to menu ideas. Cameras are getting a real upgrade. Before, it was motion detected, person detected, package detected, and you did the detective work. With Gemini, alerts become AI descriptions. A USPS delivery driver is placing a package on the porch and walking away. Your video history in the app shows these descriptions right in the timeline. To catch up fast, there's Home Brief. Each evening, it summarizes hours of footage into a quick, digestible recap with relevant clips, and you can tune it. Shorter, longer, pets, packages, whatever you care about. And when you need a specific answer, Ask Home lets you search hours or days of footage in natural language. What time did the kids get home? Did I leave the car door open? Type it in the app or ask a speaker display and jump straight to the clip. Ask Home isn't just for history. It's your new command center in the app. Start typing a device or automation name, and it surfaces what you need. Fire off nuanced commands in one sentence. Turn on all the lights, except for the kitchen lights, and lock the front door. Ask, "What lights are on?" or "Are my doors locked?" Then create automations by describing them. Turn on the porch lights and lock the front door every day at sunset. Or even turn different lights on and off throughout the evening to make it look like someone is home. No programming. Just describe what you want. The Google Home app itself is rebuilt as the single hub. It's faster and more reliable, and it folds in full controls for older Nest cameras, doorbells, thermostats, and locks. The new version focuses on three screens: home, activity, and automation. And live views load 30% faster than before. Reviewing camera footage is smoother. Scrub the timeline and the video adapts speed so you can skim without missing the moment. Update to app version 4.0 plus today, and if you want early access to Gemini for Home, tap your profile icon, go to Home Settings, then Early Access to enroll. On hardware, there's a new portfolio engineered for Gemini. Google's launching three Google Home cameras right now. The third-gen Google Nest indoor camera, wired, is $100 and bumps to 2K resolution with improved night vision, a wider field of view, and more color options. The third-gen Google Nest outdoor camera, wired, is $150. Also 2K, and adds a new UV protective coating. The The Google Nest Video Doorbell, wired, is $180, pushes 2K resolution, a wider head-to-toe field of view, and zooms during event capture, so reviewing footage is easier. They're on sale starting today, October 1st. Two notes from hands-on. There are no battery-powered models in this wave. Previous Nest generations had wireless options, and Google is doubling the free storage to 6 hours of 10-second clips from cams or the doorbell, which is generous compared to competitors that lock basics like package, person detection, and any storage behind a paywall. Speaking of paywalls, subscriptions are changing. The old Nest Aware is gone. In its place is Google Home Premium, a whole home plan that unlocks Gemini for home capabilities on all compatible devices, including older security cams, Nest speakers, and smart displays. Plans start at $10 a month. Google Home Premium is also included with Google AI Pro and Ultra at no extra cost. The base voice assistant upgrade, Gemini replacing Google Assistant on your speakers and displays, is included with your device. The more advanced stuff, Gemini Live, AI-powered notifications with those descriptions, Home Brief, Ask Home for video history, and creating automations by voice, lives behind Google Home Premium. Activation stays, hey Google, but you're waking Gemini for home now. And compatibility is wide. Google's making it backward compatible to 2015, so if you've got a Google Home or Nest device from the last decade, it's slated to get Gemini for home. Third-party smart speakers aren't included right now. There's also a new Google Home speaker coming in spring 2026 for $100. It's built specifically for Gemini, offers 360-degree sound, and looks like a Nest Mini that went to the gym. No new smart display announced yet, but it sounds like something could follow. For developers, this is a platform moment. Through works with Google Home, over 800 million devices are already connected via Google Home cloud-to-cloud APIs and Matter. Gemini's conversational control will just work with those integrations. No extra dev work for the core benefits. But Google is urging partners to test now as the rollout begins, and says improved data and tools for monitoring performance and reliability land later this year. There's also a new program to help partners build the next generation of AI cameras. It includes a hardware reference design with recommended SoCs, image sensors, and an approved vendor list, plus a common Google Home camera embedded SDK, same framework across Nest and partner cams, that unifies live view and event history with Google Home's camera and intelligence cloud. The system uses a split compute model. On-device ML generates keyframes and metadata, sends them to the camera cloud, and the cloud preserves and prioritizes that alongside the event video for features like Gemini AI descriptions. First partner out of the gate is Walmart, with the on-end indoor camera wired and on-video doorbell wired, delivering up to 1080p live view resolution and intelligent alerts at affordable prices. Fully integrated across speakers, smart displays, phones, tablets, watches, TVs, web, and partner apps built on the Google Home APIs. That's the state of play. A conversational home, faster app, smarter cameras, a new subscription, and a clear path for both new devices and the ones you already own. More to come as the rollout expands. See you in the next one.